We are going to start our problem with a triangle who has two sides in a relation of 2 to 1, as you can see on the sketch. Then, from the apex of this triangle, we will pull another line to the bottom side. This line will have the length of 10, and it will also bisect the upper angle into two angles of 60 degrees, as you can see on the sketch. Now, the question is, can we somehow calculate the length of the third line of the triangle? This problem was sent to me by one of my subscribers, Matt, who said that this problem was given to him in a math competition in his senior year in high school. So thank you, Matt, for the wonderful suggestion. And of course, I will urge you guys to pause the video right now, try this problem for yourself, post the solution down in a comment section, and then, of course, come back and check the solution which I will provide. Just one more thing. For God's sakes, do not scale this image. This is just a representation of a problem, and it is not in a true scale. Alright, so with this out of the way, let's solve our problem. So first I will label all the vertices of a triangle as A, B, and C, and I will label the bottom intersection point as D, as you can see on the sketch. Now, since we know that the side BC is 2 times bigger than the side AC, from the theorem we know that the side DB will also be 2 times the side AD. Well, if you're wondering which theorem states this, this theorem is actually called the angle bisector theorem, and it states that an angle bisector in a triangle divides the opposite side into two segments that are proportional to the other two sides of the triangle. So I have labeled all the vertices on the sketch on the right the same as the sketch on the left, so that you can easily follow. Now, let's use this proportion on the sketch on the left. We can substitute the value for the side BC and AC for 2x and x, and after simplifying, we will get that DB over AD equals to 2, which means that DB must be equal to 2AD, and this is our original assumption. Now, if you're not familiar with this awesome angle bisector theorem, you can actually use the law of sines, and I'm going to show you this way as well. So first, let's label the acute angle at the point D as alpha. This means that the other side of this angle must be 180 degrees minus alpha, since those two angles are supplementary. Next, we will use the law of sines. Just as a quick reminder, the law of sines states that the relation between the sine of an angle and the opposite side of the triangle is equal for the whole triangle. So we can use this in our favor. First, let's take a look at the blue triangle ADC. And if we use the law of sines, we can get that sine alpha over the opposite side of x is equal to the sine of 60 degrees over the opposite side AD. We can use the same thing on the red triangle DBC. We can say that sine of 180 degrees minus alpha over the opposite side 2x is equal to the sine of 60 over the opposite side DB. Now we can simplify this 180 minus alpha, because from the trigonometry we know that the sine of the supplementary angles is equal. So we can simplify this to sine alpha. So now we can use those two equalities. Remember, we are looking for the relation between the side DB and AD. So, in order to get that, we are just going to divide those two relations. And if we do this, you can see that we can easily cancel sine alpha and sine of 60 degrees, and we are left with the following. Now we can simplify everything with x and get that 2 equals to dB over AD, which means that dB must be equal to 2 times AD, and again, we have the same assumption. Alright, so now let's go ahead and label the side AD as Y and DB as 2Y. Now we will ask trigonometry to help us once more. We will now use the law of cosines. Just as a quick reminder, this law states that the square of any side of the triangle equals to the sum of the squares of the other two sides minus 2 times the product of those sides times the cosine of angle in between those two sides. So, we're going to use this law first in our blue triangle ADC, and we will use it on the side Y. So, y square will be equal to x square plus 10 square minus 2 times x times 10 times the cosine of the angle between x and 10, which is 60 degree angle. From the trigonometry, we know that cosine of 60 degrees is equal to 1 over 2. So we're going to substitute this and simplify. And finally, we will get that y square equals to x square plus 100 minus 10x. Now, let's repeat the law of cosines, but this time for the red triangle DBC and for the side of 2y. And if we do this, we will get the following. Again, we know that cosine of 60 equals to 1 over 2, and we will do the same simplification as before, and finally we will get that 4y square equals to 4x square plus 100 minus 20x. Alright, so now we are going to use those two equations which we got, and we're going to use them as a system of equation in order to find the value of x and y. You can actually do this in multiple ways, but for this problem, I will expand the top equation with 4 and get the following. Then I will rewrite the second equation, and I will just subtract those two equations. If we do this, you can see that 4y square will cancel and also 4x square. And we're going to get that 0 is equal to 300 minus 20x, which means that 20x is equal to 300, so x has the value of 15. Now, this is really cool because in this way we found out the lengths of the sides AC, which is 15, and BC, which is 30. But in order to find the value of y, we're just going to replace the value of x back into our first equation. Then we will get the following. Now we're just going to work through this and get that y squared is equal to 175, which means that y is equal to square root of 175. This really nicely simplifies as 5 root 7. Remember, we are looking for the side AB of our triangle, and this side equals to the sum of the segments y and 2y, which equals to 3y. Now we're just going to substitute the value of y, and we will get that the length of this side is 3 times 5 root 7, which means that the length of our wanted line is equal to 15 square root of 7 units, and this is our awesome solution. So, I really hope you guys enjoyed this problem. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel, those stuff really means a lot. And of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below, as you always do. And until next time, see you guys and take care!